I'm telling you, don't get the Father involved, because he'll send a flood your way. And he won't send Katrina. He'll send Noah's flood. How about if you got caught up in Noah's flood and the ark was sailing away and you were in your Catholic church, in your confessional going, God forgive me, please, of my adulterous affair with my neighbor. Please, listen, I understand. They don't tell you that you can be free from sin. They don't tell you that God can empower you by the Holy Ghost and you'll walk in power over sin. They won't tell you that in there because you won't come back. Because you'll start to evangelize and you'll start to know the truth. And the truth sets you free.
Drunk atheist on Bourbon Street tonight. Jesus said, how I wish you were either hot or cold. But because you are lukewarm, I will spew you out of my mouth. So Jesus' own words say that lukewarm Christians make Jesus puke. Your Catholic Church, there are truths. This is why it's so dangerous. At least the drunk atheist on Bourbon Street, he knows he's not saved. He knows that if there is a hell, he's going there. But Catholics and people of other false religions, they believe sincerely in their heart that they are fine with God. You come off of your drunken stupor from Bourbon Street Saturday night, get up in time to go to Mass on Sunday morning, and you tell God you're sorry for your drunkenness, only to go back out tonight and get wasted again. You need to take a look at who your friends are today. When you were coming out, who were the people protecting you from us? All the tarot card readers, all the palm readers, all the fortune tellers, all the witches here on Jackson Square, we're all there making a blockade and giving you handshakes and peace signs, shaking your hands. You know why? Because you're the feeding of their customers. Why are they set up on Jackson Square? Because you provide them with customers. If the bar owners were smart, they'd stand out here with coupons, handing it out to your congregation after Mass for tonight's drunkenness. If the strip club owners were smart, they'd be out here with coupons for you to go to the strip clubs tonight, because they know you Catholics are hypocrites. You come in for your 1 hour of time per week to thank God. You come in and do your little 1 hour time with God, then go right back out onto Bourbon Street and you melt in just with all the other heathens. Do you understand the lies that are going on in the Catholic Church? Purgatory. Nowhere in the Bible. I grew up a Catholic. Most of my family is still Catholic. And purgatory is the lie of the devil that would have put me personally into hell. Because I thought only the popes and the Mother Teresa's go right to heaven. Only the Hitlers and the rapists and people who miss Mass 3 times in a row are the ones who go to hell. And everybody else gets to go to purgatory. So all I did was try to be good enough to not be one of the worst going to hell and just do my time in purgatory. Well, purgatory is a lie of the devil. How many millions and billions of people are in hell right now thinking they were going to just do their little penance in purgatory, and they are in hell right now and the devil is laughing at them. And you pray to Mary. What is your obsession with Mary? Even if Mary could hear your prayers, do you see nothing wrong with praying a rosary when you're praying to Mary 10 times for every 1 time you're praying to God? Something is wrong. The only time in the Bible it ever talks about speaking to dead humans is called an abomination. It's called necromancy, and it is an abomination. What happened to King Saul? King Saul had the Holy Spirit residing in him, and he knew God's will, but eventually he turned from God, and the Holy Spirit left him. So what did he do? He couldn't hear from God anymore. Just like the Catholic Church, they can't hear from God. So what did King Saul do? It grieved him. He couldn't hear from God anymore. So he went to the witch at Endor to say, conjure up Samuel. I need some advice. I need some advice from a dead human. I need to talk to a dead human. And the witch at Endor brought up Samuel, and it ended up costing Saul his life and the life of his sons. You are praying to dead humans who cannot hear you, even if Mary could hear you. Are you saying that Mary is omniscient? If you had a billion Catholics all praying to Mary at the exact same time, is Mary now omniscient that she can hear a billion people's prayers? The Bible says that we have one mediator between man and God, and that is the Lord Christ Jesus. Why do you want to go to dead humans with your prayers when God will receive your prayers directly? Why are you going into a little dark box to tell some priest about your sins when you can confess them to God directly? Do you understand that Jesus never once called Mary mother? Used the word mother, it wasn't addressing her directly. Jesus said, woman, behold thy son, speaking about John, the Apostle John. And John, behold thy mother. When he used the word about Mary concerning himself, it was only the word mother. I mean, only the word woman, not mother. Jesus did not raise her up above himself or put her equal. Do you know what the first Hail Mary ever said was? Do you Catholics even know what happened when Jesus heard the first Hail Mary ever said? Let's do a little Bible study, because I know you don't know it. You don't read your Bible. In Luke, chapter 11, 27 and 28, attention Catholics, this is a history lesson, the first Hail Mary ever said. A woman said, it came to pass, as she spake these things, a certain woman in the company lifted up her voice and said unto him, blessed is the woman, blessed is the womb that bare thee, and the paps which thou hast sucked. But Jesus said,